You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment. Very good, Gene Johnson.
AfterBuzz TV. From the AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies, this is AfterBuzz TV's Dancing with the Stars After Show. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest news and gossip. And now, another post-game wrap-up show for your favorite TV show. It's AfterBuzz TV's Dancing with the Stars After Show.
Hey, guys. Welcome to another after show of Dancing with the Stars, season 18, week 5 already, Disney week. We have a small crew here today. As you can tell, I am not Kristen Burt. Kristen Burt is away on business and can't join us via phone either, so we will miss her.
We are missing her a lot.
We miss her so much, I feel like crying.
Miss you, Kristen.
We do. We love you, Kristen. Fans out there that are watching, I am not Kristen. Don't expect me to be Kristen. I'm Suri, and we're going to have fun today. So let me introduce my co-hosts.
Hi, everybody. I'm Anna Tribunskaya.
And over there.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jules Tucker.
Yes.
I say it better.
And you were all expecting, and we were too, our lovely pro, Henry Bialikov. And as you can see, he is not here in studio. It was a last minute. He had to pull out. He's been injured and taking care of his injuries.
Oh.
However, rest assured, he will be joining us sometime at a future date. So sorry of all of you fans. I know you. I can hear you screaming now because he has a huge fan base.
He does. Yes. And why wouldn't he? I mean, look at him.
A massive talented fan base. Yeah, and he's a close friend of AfterBuzz TV. He's come on every season, and thank you for that. But he will be joining us soon. Yeah. So let's dive into things because Disney Week, amazing.
What show.
The first time in 18 seasons that they've done
that.
Disney.
And I said that when I was on set, I said, why have they never done this before? I couldn't believe that.
Right.
Considering that ABC is part of Disney.
Well, Disney owns ABC, so you thought that they would have done it before, but maybe they were saving it for when they really wanted, wanted it. You know?
Maybe. Know. Who knows? It's one of those things that we probably will never know the answer to that. But I'm glad that they did it. And we've got to talk about the guest judge, former Dancing with the Stars winner in 2009, Donny Osmond. Mm-hmm. What did you guys think of Donny as a judge?
I know Donny personally, and I've interacted with him off camera, and I love him personally. I think he's great. I love him as a performer, as an entertainer. I have a huge respect for him. I'm a huge fan of him, actually. I didn't think he was the best yesterday.
Why?
There's just a couple of things, I don't know, maybe the thing with him and Bruno doing this whole thing kind of rubbed me off the wrong way.
They were definitely chatty. And
I was right behind them.
Last week. So some people love it and they think it's fun, and I had fun with it. It didn't bother me. But some people, it's like, okay,
We were sitting right behind him, Gleb and I, last night, actually. And it was the whole time, it was
The real scoop comes from this.
Yeah. But I think they were just having, I was in studio last night, and so I got a real different look than what you guys had seen, because all the animation was added, but I couldn't see it, obviously, because I'm watching it live, and I was trying to sneak on the monitors, you know, when I can, to see, because they had these TVs up really high or out the back.
Right,
you can look right up high or just turn your head a little bit to have a look at all the animation. I'd seen a couple of rehearsal tapes, which looked amazing, all the extra bits.
Right, the animation was stunning.
And I haven't watched it back yet, so I can't wait to watch all the animation on the playback. Maybe tonight I'll have a look.
Right, because live, you don't obviously see that. So when Cheryl and
Drew
were going, there was a lot of space between that one section of choreography.
And with Max and Meryl as well, which is great. Right. I think, going back to Donny, and going back to, there are a couple of pointers that he gave, I think what he said to Cody, right?
Mm, yes. Yeah.
Was spot on. I agreed with him 100%. And then there were what he said to Amy, again, I agree with him 100%. But then there are just other times, it's kind of just a tiny bit these people are like looking up to you. I mean, being a judge, and I know what it's like because I judge competitions occasionally. Mm. It's kind of it's an honorary but awful spot. Yeah. At the same time, you have this honor and people like looking up to you, but at the same time, you kind of have their
life in your
hands. Life a little bit in your hands, right? Bit, their yeah. results, their but marks, yeah, sure. their not. I mean, again, it's Dancing with the Stars, so it's not a big deal, but you can make it or break it for some people. And so there's a certain level of respect that I, as a judge, give to people who I'm judging, which is like, you're there, you showed up, you are doing your best, so I'm gonna respect you for doing that. So it's kind of like if I'm judging a competition and I'm having a cup of coffee and a sandwich at the same time, like that's just, I wouldn't, you know, you wouldn't do that. So there's a certain level of respect that I feel has to be given to, and not that he was disrespectful, but it was just like, He was like so happy to be back. I feel like he was having really so happy. Much fun, yeah. And he was having a great time. He said, "I feel like he was nervous to judge."
He said he was nervous to judge, right. and I also think that because he was a previous contestant, it's a great
a lot
way
of pressure though.
Pressure, but I think being a former contestant, he understands what they go through. Right. So I feel like there was definitely a level of respect, but I understand your point of view as well. Right.
When Donnie first came in, he sat down, and what I liked about this was that he stated straight away that he's not here to mark the technical side of things.
Right.
Because he is not a professional ballroom trained dancer, whatever. And he said he was going to judge everyone on the performance qualities, which I thought from the word go was awesome to hear, because that was nice to know that that was what he was just looking right. at.
Because right. you know he's I mean? A performer, and he—that's what he understands. Kind of like me, I'm not a ballroom expert like Correct. You two. I'm a dancer, but perform. I focus on performance.
Sure.
So I get it. That
sure.
makes sense.
So I liked to hear that from him, because also I felt like it gave like the other guys on the panel, like, yeah, they are there for that, and I'm here for this. So we all know our place this week, and that's what I'm going to do. And also for everyone at home, you knew what he was going to look at, so it wasn't like, you know, you had the who's the judge 2 weeks ago, the guest. Before Julianne, sorry.
Before Julianne, was it Robin Roberts?
Robin Roberts.
Yeah. So I'm not sure so much of what... She didn't say that when she sat down, though, I don't think. She had another idea. But that was cool. But we heard from Donnie straight away. So I enjoyed his comments. Some of them and some scores could have been a little bit...
Yeah.
Not dodgy, but could have been too high or too low.
Well, let's break every couple,
Here we go. Let's see go.
Can we talk about the best part, though? Can we talk about the best part?
What's the best
part? The opening number?
Well, yes, of course. The opening number.
Mandy Moore.
But like this particular opening number was so good. I loved it.
It was really good. You know what I loved about it?
Yeah.
I loved that all the pros, especially, and everybody, the whole cast, but especially there was something extra that they really looked like they were having the most amazing time.
There was a buzz in there. I walked in really late to the studio.
Yeah.
And I walked in as they were doing the rehearsal. Like before they go live, they didn't used to do this so much, but now we get to rehearse like one or two goes with music full on. So it's really nice. But and I walked in just as they were rehearsing for the first time before we went live. And there was just this buzz in the studio this week, and the music, and because it was Disney, and there was a lot of children and kids in the audience, which was a really beautiful, nice thing as well, I thought. Nice. It had a little different feeling in there this week. And it just like sent shivers down my spine. It was really cool. Yeah. I really enjoyed it.
The costumes in that number.
I loved it.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. What did you love?
My favorite part, I like the opening with the princesses. I like that. And then the three guys with canes.
Yes.
So cool.
Oh my gosh. What about when they lifted the girls up on the canes? That was like one of my favorite
Right?
Movies. So great. Wouldn't you have loved to have been on that
cane?
Oh
my gosh. There are a couple of weeks on Dancing with the Stars that they have like the theme weeks. And one of my favorite ones is like the classical week that they had and the Broadway week. I've been fortunate to do the classical week, but then the Broadway week, I was just this short. I got eliminated the week before. And then this, because again, I love Disney. I grew up watching Disney.
Same
and
here.
I think everybody did. So I was like watching, yesterday was the first time and I was like, oh, I wish I was there
doing this. We all say the same thing. And Kim Johnson was actually like, I wanted to be Tinkerbell this week.
Oh my gosh.
Like, I wanted to be there too.
Kim would have been an amazing Tinkerbell.
Oh, Kim.
She would have been perfect. And I would have rocked the Ariel.
Oh, you would,
I would have
100%.
And I've suggested that song, Under the Sea, and From the song from Aladdin for Quick Step 2. So many times, and they're like, no.
It's a shame. This was an awesome week to be in.
And I'm like, come on, you can probably clear it more than any. I mean, this is Disney. You can clear it.
Right.
But it was just unfortunate because that would have been so much fun.
Maybe another season. Oh. All right, let's get into the dances.
Let's do this.
Up first, Drew and Cheryl doing the quick step to Friend Like Me in Aladdin. Anna, what'd you think?
I loved everything performance. I think I'll agree with the judges here because I love their outfits. I mean, obviously, theme was great. I think Drew looked dashing in his kind of 1001 Arabic Nights outfit. Mm-hmm. And Cheryl looked super cute as Princess Jasmine. Mm-hmm. And the whole animation, everything is so cool around it. The dancing, though, there are a couple of things that are like, it's not that he's not the strongest dancer. Yeah. Let's all agree.
No,
about
he's
that.
Not.
He's not the strongest that. Dancer. Yeah. He is very charismatic and he is improving. I do would love to see him be more consistent with his frame.
Right.
Cause even I feel like there are a couple of moments where they had an opportunity to have a close hold and have a proper frame and they sort of didn't take it because
right, broke and yeah
they for whatever reason, because Drew needed a break and Cheryl choreographed cleverly and said, oh, you know, well, we're gonna have an animation here, which is fine, that's not even what I'm talking about, but she said maybe like in this moment let's not worry about so much about the frame, let's just do the feet. But the quick step is the point of it is that you have to stay in frame, and that's what makes it so difficult and challenging but also so cool to look at. Mm-hmm. And then there was, you know, it's just I was like, yeah. Take this chance and improve your frame and be consistent with it. And why not?
Well, you know, Cheryl's got to be working on that.
Absolutely.
She's a great instructor. Len did say it was not good technique. Yeah. How did you feel about it, Jules?
Yeah, I agree with everyone. I agree with Len and with you also, Dallin. I think I would have liked to have seen a little bit more. Same, like, I love my ballroom and I love my classic ballroom as well.
You like
and
your classic ball.
I love, you know, I love a good frame, a posture, and, you know.
Now,
and,
do you and love technique. It or you love
I
it?
I love it.
You love it.
We're retiring that soon.
Yeah, after this week, we're going to get rid of that new word. And I thought, yes, we know Drew's the performer. We know that. We know he's got the character. We know he's going to always deliver that on the floor. Now, it's been consistent every single time from week one. So we got that down. So, mate, what I want to see is from him would be to really step it up in the notch with the posture, the frame, like you said. And if you can, this week, I know they got Tango. I really hope that they stay in hold and he smashes that out a bit more. But you guys don't forget his age, keeping a super top line for that time as well. I just don't know. It's not easy peasy, guys. It's not.
Yeah, no, you can't. But you can't go there. You can't go there with the age situation because we have a lady that has no legs. You can't, like, you know what I mean?
I kind of agree with Anna a little bit. I mean, he got
four. And he's not that old. What is he, like, 50-something?
Yeah, that's not very old.
No, I mean, he's like my mom's age. My mom kills it.
Well, they got 4.7s. You guys, how do you guys feel about their score?
I would agree with it. 4.7s, yeah. Because it was like,
that's all right.
You know, again, if they would have like two scores, then I think they did it one season when there was a performance score and then a technical score on the performance, he would probably got all 10s. Right. But, and I would give him all 10s in the performance.
You know what I thought was?
The technique was one of the least technical performances of the night. Let's put it that way.
Right. That's true.
It was a shame that the genie was out of time with them, though, in the animation. I did see that.
Yeah.
It was slightly just out. I think Drew mentioned it, too. They did the playback. It's just slightly out. That was a real shame because that looks so cool.
Right. So, the animation was so cute.
Anyway, it looked awesome.
Well, moving on to Charlie and Sharna doing jazz. Mary
Poppins. Hold the phone.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
I can't
believe I just said that.
I can't say that.
Unreal, this performance. I loved it. I loved everything about it.
You loved it?
No, I'm not even going there. I loved it. And I got to say, the dropping the cane, which of course every reporter asks that question about the cane and judge and whatever. I'm sorry, but it's a prop. It happened. He only missed two counts.
Yeah.
Big deal. Kept going. The routine was amazing and flawless.
Sensational.
what do you think?
I was like jumping in my seat, like I was, we were actually standing there. Like, we all wanted to come on with them. Like, it got you right in the chest there. You know, it was such a cool number. I mean, Shana really pulled that out of the bag. Not she pulled out of the bag. She always does a great job every week. And with the troop guys on stage as well, little ad of that. And I really enjoyed the whole, he was having such a great time. It was so high packed energy, and it was just so full on. And I really enjoyed the whole thing. I got nothing more. What else can you say?
I love Sharna's choreography week after week, every season. What did you think, Anna?
And she looked amazing. Sorry, the costuming looked sensational. The whole show this week. Yeah. I mean, how can you stuff up Disney week? Obviously, the costuming, because you just follow the movies.
All the princesses. It's like perfect.
Everything looked just top notch. I really hope they bring this week back again, because I reckon it was a huge success.
And there's so many great Disney cartoons that they can pull from.
Oh my gosh. And I know movies. Max was complaining about not being able to be a prince, but more importantly, he wanted his girl to be a princess, not a worker girl or village girl or something. I mean, it was cute that he was complaining about it. That's how I mean it, by the way.
Well,
he was like, there's so many characters.
We'll get to them in a minute. Back to Shana and Charlie.
So what did you think of their number as a whole, Anna?
It was really spot on. Everything.
Technique-wise,
timing-wise, together. I actually have to give him props for losing the prop. And then picking it right back.
Two counts, that's all he missed.
Yes, and not really.
If the camera had panned to Shana for that minute, you wouldn't even
know
it happened.
You would not know.
On set, everyone was like, oh, did you see that? Of course I just saw that.
But that stuff happens.
It happens when you have props, and props are hard.
And that's how professional he is, to get straight back into it. Like, boom, he knew that routine inside and out.
Oh my gosh,
he was great. I love his fluffy hair back. I love it.
Having his fluffy blonde hair back.
Gotcha. I think Shana looked beautiful, and the whole troop background just added more energy, and it like fed both of them. And I almost feel like the fact that they underscored him because of the prop, like, come on.
Well,
give the guy
got
10.
Three nines and a 10.
Yeah, but
37.
I think
it should have been 10s.
I feel like it should have been all 10s.
Do you think they took a... Well, Carrie... No, that wasn't good. Was it Carrie Ann that didn't take a point? No, it was another number.
Do you think
they took a point off because of the cane? I don't think they did.
But it's still like...
I feel like that's
holding them down a little, just because he's so amazing.
Maybe.
That he's going to, you know, end up in the finale. And some people, they kind of score a little bit lower a few weeks,
maybe,
so that it's not a given that they're going to the finale. I don't know. I mean, because where do you take off points in that routine?
Well, I also feel, just in general, yesterday they were very gracious 99% of the time, 95% of the time, with their scores.
Yeah.
They were.
And they were
very... They were all on happy pills last night. It was
right?
Like, 7, 9, 10, 10.
Disney
like,
happy pills.
But Disney, I mean, Disney does it to you. I mean, they were like, kids in a Disneyland.
Oh, my gosh.
God, where are you pulling these from this week, Anna?
My cheesy joke. But they were going back to this, they were also very kind and positive with their comments, too.
They were.
Yeah, it was like...
Disney... Everywhere.
Yes.
The Disney feel.
Disney,
nice.
Even in their hearts.
They're like, let's
this
just
week.
Be nice this week.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Let's move
thing.
On.
Beautiful.
To Danica and Val doing the quick step to be our guest, Beauty and the Beast. I have to say, costume wise, this was probably the most Disney I felt. Like, I felt like I was at Disney World or Disneyland watching this number.
Or Disney at Tokyo. See, have you been to Disney Tokyo?
I've not been there.
Disney
but
Paris, maybe?
Any Disneys.
Right, okay.
I felt like
Disney.
I was there, right? You know, the costumes and everything. He blows me away with his choreo.
Val?
And there. Yes. Anna, what did you think?
As a quick step, spotless. I mean, it had literally everything a proper quick step needs to have. Plus all the cool little bits and pieces, plus the stylistically stained with the idea of Beauty and the Beast and the whole thing. I loved, again, coming back to this word, I'll find another word.
Yeah.
I was really stoked. I was really stoked to see the teacups and the butlers.
They looked hilarious.
The cupcakes and all of that. I mean, I really feel like he... I don't know if you ever watched that cartoon, but I really feel I watched it as a kid like bajillion of times, you know, as a kid, like you keep rewatching it the same again.
You wear the tape out.
And then like I would sing with, I'm not gonna sing it now because I'm awful, but no.
No singing.
It's one of my favorite cartoons, one of my favorite movies from
Beauty
Disney.
And the Beast.
Beauty and the Beast is the Ariel and then Beauty and the Beast. Those two are my top.
Okay, back to the dance.
Back to the dancing.
Thanks, Jules.
Right? Just like he watched the cartoon and he's like, how can I put that feeling of that film into a quick step? And he accomplished that. To me, I felt like I was inside the animation watching this.
He had a good one though too. He could have done that easily, which was pretty, I feel, which was pretty cool.
What?
To add in the extra characters in there as well. You know, for that one, I mean, you know, if you're doing Lion King, it's hard to like throw a few lions in there here and there. You know, when some hyenas
come running past. Well, you know, they did bring a live donkey.
They
at
did,
some
and
point.
It wouldn't. It
Are you serious?
Was it last season or the season before?
Couple
seasons ago, they brought in a live donkey to try and go. I think it was Cheryl's routine or something.
Oh,
and the donkey
God.
Did not want to play, so they had to remove the donkey. So live animals. Not so much fun on
Especially
Dancing
with
the Stars.
Especially donkeys.
No. Animals, as they say, animals and babies are the hardest.
Yes. What your take on this?
My take on the quick step. Phenomenal. Absolutely phenomenal.
What was their score?
Danica Val, let's see. I have it. 3 10s and a 9.
Yeah.
Agree.
Pretty close. I mean, it was nearly
it really
deserving
was.
All 10, nearly.
Yeah.
I mean, again, he choreographs so cleverly. He makes sure everything she does looks fantastic.
Yeah.
I feel.
Yeah, she said
that's the sense of a good choreographer, is that, you know, they always make sure that she it's not just good. About them. And especially on a show like these shows, Dancing the Stars, all that, they make sure that she always looks good. Did they say something about her technique? Was that what Len said? Some of your technique was that her or somebody else?
Maybe it
was
someone else. I don't remember that.
But because I was like, huh? But maybe that was somebody else. Yeah. But I thought. All the choreography, sometimes it was a little like smash for me at times, like harsh. I would have liked a little bit more oozy, a little bit less.
Softer.
At some points. But generally, I mean, man, he's smashed out of the ballpark.
Absolutely. She said that, you know, she likes details and he is all about details. So
and that's why they're great. They are great. And just come back to her, she probably has one of the best frame, close frame, and posture, and the way she holds her arms.
For a female pro.
For really? A female celebrity. I know, she does look like a female pro. I think most of the seasons. I've noticed that yesterday in the rehearsal, because under the dress, as much as I loved it, as much as it's, you know, the theme and everything, and I get it, it was almost distracting. I actually could see more of what kind of quality dancer she really is in the rehearsal package, where she was just wearing a simple tank top, because she has the most beautiful upper line. I mean, her lines are great. And we said that from the very beginning, her feet and her arms. And that was a little bit distracting. So I wish.
You've got to be careful. It doesn't cluster. You don't cluster yourself up, because then it looks like you lift your shoulders higher.
And the hair were kind of a lot. And this was just a little bit maybe
the thing
too
that impresses
much.
Me with Val and his partners is he seems to take somebody and he improves them every single week.
He develops
week.
Them. He makes
he really
sure that they're
does.
Moving on.
Yeah.
Right?
He takes it. He takes pride in it.
Yeah.
He enjoys
Absolutely.
It.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, their score well deserved.
Yes.
39. Everybody agrees?
Sure. Agrees.
Yeah.
All right. Moving on to one of my favorite couples of the season, Amy and Derek.
Yes.
Doing a waltz to, so this is Love, Cinderella. How perfectly appropriate for her. I'm so happy that she got Cinderella.
Mm-hmm.
And first, let's just talk about her package really quick, because she showed some emotion of frustration. You know, she remembers what it was like to have legs for 20 years and to then be on 2 inches by 1 inch and not being able to do the steps and not everything for the first time, really being super frustrated. And we all understand tears of frustration. You know, I don't think she was being overly dramatic in any way.
No.
I really felt for her. I started crying
oh
when
my
I was
gosh.
Watching that. Were
surprise.
You?
Surprise.
Yeah. Surprise.
The whole,
no, sorry.
The whole studio.
Serious tears. Surprise.
Hashtag serious tears.
Okay.
But yes,
yeah,
I cried.
Yes. And, you know, I don't even know what else to say about that other than I'm so happy that she got to feel like a princess, you know, and she looked stunning. Was she not beautiful. Dropped a gorgeous? I've watched that routine 5 or 6 times because every single time I cried, wow, not just because
you're
of
the, obsessive.
I'm not obsessive. I cried.
You have problems.
Oh God. Come on, I'm not the only one out there that cries. I'm sure people
you cry on the show every week.
No, so I didn't cry last week. I didn't cry last week. Nope. No tears. And I did not. I only cried on like 2 performances this week.
But can I say something? Sorry, when I was in studio. This is not easy. I think I said this last week. Was it with her as well? Who was crying last week anyway? But they were blocking themselves. Oh, it was Drew 1 week. He was like blocking his ears, not listening to the package because you can hear it on studio, right? And she was on the stairs and I remember I was looking at her and she was trying to hold it in, not to, you know, go back. And I could see Derek kind of trying to pull her away from like not listening to it, or like jumping around, like, you know, trying to keep the focus off it, because again, that's not easy to switch off when, you know, all the monitors are on and you can hear yourself, you know, crying and stuff. Yeah. And that sometimes, just for people at home who don't get to see that, you know, mentally you have to be so switched on and charged and ready to do this. And when you sometimes, it can just be a switch.
As like soon as the music goes, you got to be ready to go.
You know what
I
mean?
Yeah. And what he's trying to explain, which I want to also elaborate on, is, I mean, imagine being in studio and it's silent and everybody's listening to you talk and cry and say all of the things that we watched her say in the package. It's got to be really hard to not listen to it.
It's very, it strips you, really. It makes you very vulnerable. Before even you started dancing, which is kind of being a bit vulnerable because you're showing, I mean, dancing is a very emotional thing. And when you invest so much blood, sweat, and tears into it, it's really, really kind of is, you become a bit of a mush. And you should, because if you're not, then it's not true dancing, then it's not true art. You know, your soul has to show through what you're doing. And then right before you're supposed to do that, they are like adding more stuff by exactly complete silence in the studio, everybody listening to you, and you like la 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 la, try really 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 hard not to do it. And it's just like a mind game. It's Dancing with the Stars is a true mind game for the celebs. And
even the judges were like, ooh, what, like Turner, like, whoa,
I'm sorry,
whoa,
blah, blah, that,
like,
no,
they were really, even the judges were like, oh, geez, taken back by that.
I thought the number was absolutely beautiful. What did you think technique wise?
This is tough.
This is tough
to comment on.
Yeah.
Well,
because, like Derek said, how are you meant to create a rise and fall when the action can't be created from the knee down? That's where it happens.
Yeah.
So this is the problem. She physically could not do a rise and fall action. Close changes, natural turns, as basic wall steps weren't possible for her. What's he meant to do? Like you said, make up basically a new technique and work around what she could create and she could do. And they pulled you in with the feeling and the emotion and the music and the, you know, he did everything possible to keep that in there. It was a shame because I thought she would have been able to do a few pivots or something, because you know it needs so much rise and fall or something like this.
Yeah.
A little bit mixed it in, but I think it's pivots, hard, you know?
Remember from last week, she did say that pivots she can't do.
Yep, she did say
too
that.
Too hard.
Carrie Ann said that she wasn't going to take off a point because of the con. She believed it was because of Derek putting content in that for lack of stuff that she couldn't do, which I agree with.
So was it for the
lift? I don't have a problem with that.
So was it for the lift in the beginning or was it for the lift in the middle of the routine?
I'm not sure. General, do you know, Jules?
Left general, lift. I would just say.
I think because in the lift in the beginning, I almost like, okay, this is a sort of part
going
of
down the stairs, you mean?
Yeah, when he lifted her and carried her. And I thought that was very, very appropriate. And
he does that every time. Also, at the end of the routine, he lifts her and carries her over to the judges. He does the same thing every week.
But that's at the end of the dance.
At the end of the dance,
I like, this isn't, people might send hate mail to me or, you know, tweet. Hate mail in modern world means tweeting. I actually disagree with Carrie Ann for saying, I'm going to take that and not, you know, judge you like everybody else, because it's like, she doesn't need that.
But
if it's like, if they take in their, if this is the rule and Carrie Ann is like the lift
expert
officer police,
sure,
and she calls every single person on the lift, then she shouldn't treat Amy any differently, because the truth to be told, how is it then fair if one person, if when they say you're a true contender, and then the next moment they kind of go, oh, well, because you can't do this, I'm not going to worry about the lifts because I feel like it was necessary. I just don't think that's right. It's like, she's true contender. She does amazing job. I absolutely agree with Donnie for giving her 10 because it was 10 for everything and creating a new technique kind of a thing. And so, yeah. But to not take a point because of the lift, I disagree.
Well,
I think if Carrie Ann is like so strong on lifts, we'll take off that point.
Okay, hold on. I definitely see your point and agree with you on one hand. However, the judging every week from season to season, there's always gifts and there's always people that have been inconsistently scoring. So I don't. That's why I don't have a problem with it personally, because there's been.
But then
other
she
times
shouldn't have even mentioned it.
Yeah, maybe.
Then she should. Then Carrie Ann should have like not even mentioned. Oh, you did a lift, right. But don't worry about it, honey. Let me patronize you here a little bit. But like, then, that's what I felt it was. It was a little patronizing. I was like, for Amy, like, don't patronize me.
But then there'd be fans like, well, why didn't she call her on the lift?
But then they've done it before and they haven't called them on the lift.
Exactly.
This is the thing. It's happened before. So there's been other lifts and they didn't call them up and that they gave them great marks. And then someone else does a lift and just because maybe they're having a bad day that day, boom, you did a lift. Me. There you go. I'm taking down a mark.
Me. Oh boy.
Well, I mean, we can have this conversation till
sure.
the cows come
right,
home.
Right.
It's fine.
Which
but
is soon,
I just
so hurry up.
They got 3 9s and a 10. You guys would agree with
absolutely
that?
Absolutely agree. Yeah.
Definitely.
Okay. All right. Agreed. Fair enough. Before we move on to the next round of dances,
yay.
We need to talk about rating us on iTunes.
Yay!
Please go to iTunes and
you
rate us, and we would love 5 stars.
One,
five,
two, three, four.
Five. Please. And be sure to check us out because it helps us continuously bring you great content.
Yes.
So, and we've got the twins over there giving you 5s. Okay.
This is the twins corner. Usually it's Suri's.
That's right.
Corner with Suri. Twins.
All right, moving on to Cody and Whitney doing the samba. He was working the dance. That was one of my notes from Donnie. The samba to Can't Wait to Be King, the Lion King.
I just can't wait. I love this song. I love Lion King. Sorry.
I'm so excited. Go ahead. Take it, Jules.
Yeah.
What'd you think?
Well, first of all, loved the song. Didn't love the trousers he was wearing. and Whitney looked awesome. I love the whole concept of this dance. I thought it was really, really cool.
Great concept.
Again, I agree with the judges were saying. He was like, Donnie said he didn't quite enjoy it enough, go right out there. I think he was a little pulled back. The routine had a lot of content this week, which was great to see. And yeah. Whit pulled the whip. And
that's a hashtag.
Whit pulled the whip. And that was good for me. I wanted to see him being challenged more, and I thought that was great. Did it come across on set? I'm not sure. Some things didn't quite look right to me. He wasn't comfortable, could have been executed a bit better, or they could have changed it. Like sometimes probably like random framing and his feet, he was wearing the flat shoes and I didn't like that because weight can't be forward on the balls of your toes, so therefore it makes it harder to get the actions. You know, it's hard, but I thought generally better work, mate. I enjoyed it. Still could have been more samba for me.
Anna.
Well, here we go. It's like we've been saying that from week to week to week. He keeps doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And even though this routine content was much stronger and definitely was much more content of choreography, yes. Content of technique and quality, no. Mm-hmm. I did not think that there was much of samba technique from Cody.
Mm-hmm.
If we go to samba. As a whole concept, as a whole routine, performance was great. I think she looked super sexy.
Oh my gosh.
Amazing. Dignitas. Gorgeous. I actually...
The lioness.
Yeah, the pants didn't bother me. I thought the pants were quite appropriate for the look of what the kind of African-inspired outfits. So, agree with Donnie on the face, but I just think because there were more content, he was concentrating harder. He had to work really hard this week, and I wish he would have worked this hard like 3 weeks ago.
Yeah,
because I think when he first came out, he came out so strong out of the gate that everybody like, oh my gosh, this is the next Zendaya.
Right.
Mm. And he wasn't.
I didn't think he was going to be the next Zendaya, but I could see why
kinda,
people...
I kind of, you know, that flavor. And then it's funny because she was sitting right in the audience, and maybe that's why that thought came up to me. And just, he's young, he's talented, he can obviously move.
Sure.
He has great rhythm and musicality. So it's like something did not quite... I think it was mostly mental, to be honest.
I think he found it hard to connect that, to connect his head and his body and everything together and then put it on the floor.
That can happen when you're 17.
Coordinate, yeah.
Like we said.
Yeah. Coordinate.
Yeah. Like we said, yeah.
Well, we'll get to it later, but I mean, I was worried about him last week, moving on. So their scores were 2 8s and 2 9s. What did you think of?
I kind of think the nines were a bit much.
High.
Yeah. Yeah. Comparative to everything else.
Yeah, compared to like Val's Quickstep. I mean, he got a 9 and a Quickstep as well. I mean, that routine was flawless.
I wouldn't have given it a 9. I love the whole look of it all.
The look of it was fantastic.
Yeah. Okay, moving on to quite a controversial package.
Yes.
Boy.
The two parts package.
Yes.
The part one and part two.
Yes. So Nene and Tony. She was Cruella De Vil and
which was perfect for her.
The foxtrot. Yes, perfect for her.
Perfect character.
Okay, I have a lot. I'm going to go to you guys in a second, but I do want to say there's no secret out there that I am friends with Tony, so I can read his face well. And when I saw the package and her bringing up Derek, I saw his face change just like she called it out to him. I see your face changing, Tony, about Derek. And I've seen that. I've known him for years. So I wasn't surprised. I start laughing because, you know, as you know people, you can read their faces when
you're
they're
like,
not really
saying something. Oh, here we go. No, not that button. Didn't do that.
So I could see him like, oh, God. But I was pleasantly surprised that he acknowledged a little bit of insecurity and jealousy can come up when your partner goes to somebody else. And by the way, I don't think it was any mistake that Nene ended up with Derek. Just saying, because Tony's close with the producers and everybody, and everybody knows, as you guys know, things that go on and who's friendly and who's clicks, right? You know, and who goes together. And they know a little bit. You
basically
know what I'm talking about.
Basically, yes. Hollywood and Dancing with the Stars, it's the same as everywhere else in the world.
Yes.
Like high school.
Yes. Yes. Exactly. Well said, Anna. Well said. So anyway, so the whole thing for me really quick is that most of that drama is created for television. As Tony said after and post interviews and whatnot, it's 2 minutes of one day, not the whole week.
Yep.
You know, and Tony, the reason why he has good rapport with most of his partners is because he's a great teacher and he's really easy to get along with and has a good time and he does really genuinely care about his partner. Mm-hmm. So for me, it was like, whatever. It was drama. It was 2 minutes. They got it on tape, unfortunately. And that's what it was. What did you think?
About the drama or about the dance?
The drama.
Oh, the drama. We're talking about the drama. Yeah, well, it is part, which is the drama. well, listen, there are certain... This is how, and you can probably agree with me. This is when we used to compete. I used to compete. You used to compete. Mm-hmm. We would have lessons with different coaches.
Right.
With our right? Right?
Explain for people
with
that
our
don't
competitive
know.
Partners. So, like me and my partner. Let's say me and Jules are dancing together.
A fine couple.
As
we would
a, we would have. we will have really good look good together.
Ass,
are you
actually,
kidding me?
Yeah.
Our Fair accents enough. Though, we wouldn't even have to dance. We just would start talking.
Oh
and
my
like,
gosh.
Yes. Anyway, so let's say we're dancing together and then we have multiple coaches we go into. It's not like one coach, like maybe in gymnastics or figure skating. Even figure skaters have different coaches. Mm-hmm. We have like 5 or 10
choreographer,
coaches.
A technician. We have someone who really is our coach. We have a couple of people that we need just for certain styling aspects. Maybe somebody else to have a third eye.
Just
generally.
So we have like 5 coaches, right? And so, especially with male coaches, females somehow maybe have less ego. I don't know. But
there
let's say
be it first. I'm kidding. You know, sometimes.
But let's say we go and have lesson with
John.
Let's call him John.
John.
And he teaches us this certain style. And we're like, you know what? This is good. Okay. This is working. Blah, blah, blah. And then we go to Paul. And just randomly, just saying a name. And Paul teaches us something and you go like, wow, this is actually really cool too. Mm. And then we go back to John and go, well, when we went to Paul, Paul did this. And then the moment you said that, immediately it's like
John switches
off and he feels disrespected and he feels like we're comparing now John to Paul. Because you just don't do that.
Well, ego gets in the way a little bit.
But yeah, but also as a student, you just don't do that. Mm. You gotta respect your teacher. I understand her views. She's like, well, what's the big deal? I was trying to genuinely actually contribute into the partnership and say, this is what I learned.
Yeah.
But maybe it just, the way she said it.
Correct.
Instead of saying, this is what I learned, and this is what I can do. This is what I can do now.
Well, hey, this is what I got from last week.
Yeah, how can you, my teacher and my partner, implement it? Instead, she said, "Well, Derek taught me this, and Derek taught me that, and Derek da da da, and da 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 da." And so that
she was winding.
Oh, winding him up.
I don't think that was done on purpose. I really don't think that Nini did it to be mean or something like that. I just think she didn't think of it.
But
I didn't think twice.
I would like to add that she did say that she could tell right away that he was not comfortable with the Derek conversation because she's like, I can read you, Tony. I can read you.
Well, it's like, listen, let me spell it out for you. It's like you have a boyfriend and then you breaking up with him and then you start dating for a quick second with another guy and then you're like, yeah, you know what, they didn't work out.
She's
and
on
you
fire this week.
And then you like go back to your boyfriend and then you say, well, this dude that I dated for a couple of days brought me flowers every day. It's like this, you know what I mean? You just don't compare things like that. You don't bring up your exes to your new relationship.
She could have done it in a way. She could have done it in a way that was like, oh, hey, last week with Derek, I did this little thing, blah 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 blah. Could I kind of use it in the routine?
Don't even mention the name.
Or just say, hey, I learned this bit. Can we use that?
This helped me out last
week. Plus, hey, she's a housewife, right?
Right.
She's a wife.
Correct.
She knows how to push people's buttons and wind up and make a good package. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, it's true. That's true.
That's all I'm saying.
She does not hold back.
No.
No. And yeah, it was nothing.
The whole thing is I wanted people at home maybe to understand a little bit better how in the ballroom world, what is the appropriate things to do and not to do and why Tony would react a certain way.
And thing is, we all know Tony and it's just such a shame because he got made out to look like such a bad guy, which I felt was really bad because he's not like that. And I think everyone knows that anyway.
Tony can be moody.
He can be moody.
Are you kidding? He cares.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
But in the package, though, he didn't look like he was losing the plot and like getting like that. You know what I mean?
But he did look frustrated. You
he
could
looked
see
annoyed. Yeah, that she getting... kept going on and on and she on. Did, I'll be frustrated too. I'll be like, go take a minute.
Yeah.
And then walking out of rehearsal is quite disrespectful.
Let's get to their... Let's get to their actual dance. What did you guys think of their dance?
The actual dance was great. I agree with the judges. It was one of their best dances. Choreography was awesome.
Carrie Ann said it was his best choreography ever.
I don't believe that.
Well, I don't think it. He did pretty awesome stuff.
Maybe she was a little excited with the Disney.
I think
so. Yeah, she was on those happy pills.
I think I remember Tony doing some banging choreography with Melissa.
Yes.
Hello. Yeah. So. But I do feel for...
I think he was like, huh? Really?
But I do feel for Nini, it was her best dance. Mm. This was her best dance. And as much as it was the dance from the previous week was well suited for her, which in a sort of expected way, but whatever. But this dance, I feel like, and I think that's what Carrie Ann said, that you guys had a hurdle and you work through it. And that was really a blessing in disguise for you because it just made you stronger and it kind of lit up a fire up your butts a little bit. And I think that's what she was saying. And of course, Tony got it all personal again. It's like, oh no, I don't think so. I disagree about last week. So
I know what he disagreed with was that he didn't think it was beneficial to do a partner switch up.
Right.
Yeah. Which but I respect that feeling.
I think that's he's talking about from his perspective.
Right.
But from the outsider's perspective, they gotten so much stronger in 1 week. She gotten so much stronger.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They together as a partnership got so much stronger. And listen, she didn't go home.
Right.
Like exactly. Next week, who knows what she's going to bring. She might bring something awesome, even more awesome next week.
I found she's a good performer. Jules, what did you think?
I really thought she tried harder this week too, even if it was because they came back from the switch up. And generally, I thought the whole cast tried harder this week with everything they were doing. I loved, like, she had some massive kicks lines in there going Gorgeous. On. She was, like, really going all out. I would have liked to see a little bit more again in Hold.
Foxtrot.
But I know Foxtrot, this one's American Smooth Foxtrot, so you can break Hold and all that, and that's cool. Her feet, she was up
a couple of footworks, though.
Yeah, but mostly she was taking proper technical steps, like
toe heel, heel, toe heel.
Like this sort of stuff she was doing, I was really surprised and
you
pointed.
You just lost our viewers, toe heel, heel,
sorry.
Toe, toe, toe.
And her footwork was correct, which a couple of times I was like, wow, she was really trying. And with a few things she was doing, a lot of it was broken hold, but you know, it was okay.
But it suited the dance. It suited the character. She stayed in the character. They did that song justice. She did that character justice, and it was great overall.
Four nines. Would you guys agree with
that? I thought a bit high, to be honest.
Bit high.
Yeah.
Bit high.
I mean, was it better than Drew?
Well, if that's too high, then there was other ones that were definitely too high.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
it was the same as Drew for me.
To me, it was the same as Drew. Yes. Amazing performance.
Okay.
Couple technical things that could have been better.
That's fair. Mm. All right. Well, let's move on to James and PETA doing contemporary Let It Go on the Frozen soundtrack, which is the number one soundtrack right now. And that song will not leave my head. It's literally, I'm walking around and I'm not a singer, and I'm walking around singing like I'm a singer, which is horrible for everybody around me.
Try it in the shower. It always sounds better in the shower.
Yeah, it's brutal. But,
the acoustics are better in the shower.
I loved this number, and I'm not the only one, but I also cried in this number, but I think because it made me want to be in love. I want to be in love, and it made me want to be in, like, that feeling. I'm sure I'm not alone. Tell me I'm not alone, people.
No, you're not. I hear you.
Oh, God.
Jules, go. What do you think of this number?
I love this number. everything was set so beautifully, and it was simple and not basic, but it was simple and clear and lines and shapes and lifts, and he smacked in the lift at the end.
Yeah.
Nailed it. And that lift had never been done before on the show.
The one-arm press?
Yeah. One-arm press has never been done before is why it was in there. So he nailed that. And I know that was stressful before the show. I saw Pete and she said, we were so stressed that last lift is still not quite like...
You said it wasn't working.
Like working. It wasn't quite working. And
He nailed it. He almost didn't.
Almost
right?
On the coming down. Yeah. And then I was like, spin. Just cover up. Cover up.
Just don't drop her.
I think I yelled out. I was like, spin. And also, you know what? That's the first time that I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, since Karina, that a female pros got all 10s first in the competition.
I've done that.
What I know.
Okay, that's good to know. I didn't even know that.
At this time of the competition, you know
right.
what I mean?
Like, oh, yeah. Week
at this
five.
Week five, yeah. female week pro, five. No
he
one's ever done that before.
A real contender.
Yeah.
He is.
He's mentally switched on. Mentally switched on. That's one thing he has control of is his head. And when he's doing things, I think.
And as we know, if anyone knows anything about athletics, that's everything. Mental
yes.
is...
Yeah.
Is everything.
Yeah.
It's more than the physical part.
Yeah. The only, again, I thought that whole number was brilliant and beautiful and breathtaking. The choreography was just so spot on. And I,
not too much either. Not too much that it was overbearing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Not too overpacked that he was uncomfortable or lost in it. He was well rehearsed again, which helps a lot. Now, I mean, how cool the graphics too, right?
So cool. That was one of my favorite parts.
How awesome was that? Now, they were doing a nice little piece when all the sides were coming up and stuff. And in the dress run, I knew that there was a bridge. And I haven't seen the playback. Did the bridge come out? They did have a bridge that they were running across. And I think they took it out because it didn't quite work. And it was a real shame because it looked stunning as well.
Right.
Yeah, it's a shame, but the graphics were amazing for that one, right?
I had chills the whole time.
They had to put down an extra white thing on the floor for all that.
Oh, yeah. Well.
Yeah, they had to put down a whole other thing.
But that doesn't matter because in the contemporary,
no.
Bare feet.
But just so people at home know that, like, when that's all changing, there's, like, a whole different floor going down. There's, you know, there's like, 25, 30 people on and off that floor and those air brakes.
They
like,
do. Boom. I mean,
production, it's... Production, fan-freaking-tastic.
They are. It's a well-oiled machine over there.
They do, and it's so well. One little tiny itty bitty criticism, and maybe there's something to do with the movie. I have not seen the film yet.
As well.
But it's like, just not too stoked about his shirt. The shirt was distracting to me. I'm sorry. It's like you go into a black tie event in like flip-flops and shorts. You know what I mean? It's
there was like a reason behind that. I heard that that's what he wore, that color.
No, the color is fine. The color is fine. It's like, not about the color. It was like a very casual shirt. Like
a cotton Henley shirt.
It was a cotton Henley, like something to do on a Sunday afternoon when you take a dog out. Not when you're on Dancing with the Stars during Disney week and you like the Prince Charming. Like just maybe put like, make it a silk or something.
We'll put your considerations forward to wardrobe Henley for next week. Yeah. Thank you, Anna.
You don't have to even rhinestone it. You know what I mean?
Well, he requested it apparently.
Yeah, but come on. Like,
I get you. She didn't bother me so much.
He's in jammies and she's in the ball gown. Like it's just, come on. Like, hey, finish product here. We're talking about, I have no idea what accent I'm here.
Yeah.
Sure. Did you like this number?
I really, really did.
Yeah.
Very much so. They got a perfect score, 40.
Dancing.
Boom.
Boom. Right? Deserved. Absolutely.
Hell yeah, baby.
Yeah. I'll beautiful. Probably watch it again.
Yeah.
Okay. We move on to Meryl and Max doing this the samba
fun.
For Jungle Book. And there was a
this
lot
was
of him.
Fun.
Yeah, it was, right? It was
yeah.
Super fun. Who wants to go? Go, take it.
Why do I, whenever we have to talk about Max, why do I go first?
I will.
Is it because I'm Russian? Is this what's going on?
Yeah.
Is it racial profiling here?
Yeah.
Yes, that's it.
Okay. Well, it was very cute. It was very fun to see Max being playful and not too serious. And he's like, oh, I don't do comedy. But I think he kind of does. He actually does when he's put in this situation.
In his own way.
He can do it. And she's just gorgeous. I mean, her technique is really impeccable. Her footwork was beautiful. I did notice, though, that she was wearing flat shoes, flat heels.
I noticed that, too.
And I'm like, I wonder if she's just uncomfortable wearing high heel shoes. And he probably was like, you know what, just forget it. Just wear flats. It's fine.
Yeah, she hasn't had a problem in high heels, has she?
Right. I don't know why they chose to wear. I mean, sometimes things happen when the last minute, you know what? Just wear flats. Like, that's fine. I mean, it was like an inch and a half heel. But to me, I would love to see her in heels just because I'm biased like that. And I think
it looks better.
I hope they do
better,
rumba.
Yeah.
Have they done a rumba yet?
I hope they don't do rumba bare feet, okay? Because it's been done.
Smack her in some heels and get some proper leg action.
Get some heels because she has beautiful footwork and great lines and amazing balance. I thought technically this dance from her was just on the money.
Jules?
Yeah, this was so fun and the package was so funny.
The package was funny.
Yeah, the package. Everyone's packages this week I thought were really, really entertaining.
Enjoy.
Yeah, the music in the set and he was just lying down, juggling the fruit, just like chilling out. I thought this was real cool. I want to be in the Disney
week.
I
like that he says, you know, that she's rekindled his, you know, passion for dance or whatever the
aww.
Words he said, you know, that it's because of her. And you can tell in all their interviews after the show, I mean, they are like locked in.
Yeah.
Arm in arm, attached. Like, they have definitely a soul connection.
Yeah.
For sure. Like, an honest face. Like, you never know. Maybe it's only enough dating.
Like, that would be
that,
first.
Sorry.
Yeah, that would be a first.
Not to go too far. The package, one of my favorite parts was that he called himself Mowgli but on steroids.
Yeah,
I thought
that
was hilarious.
That was really funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, he is humorous. He has
he,
got a sense of humor.
He has a sense of humor.
He just
doesn't
bring
let
it
us
out
see
all,
it.
All the time. All
we
the
should
time.
See it. We should
100%. No, but this was an awesome samba. I thought it was really fun, and the music and the setting, everything. She had a lot of content in there, and I mean,
it's good.
I love what she brings to the floor. I love her, and she's like a Disney princess herself.
Exactly.
Right, that's why he wanted her to be a
and
princess.
And that's it's a shame that switched it up. But
she
delivers every week, and that's what I love about her. She's going to deliver. Now, let's see what else you can deliver next week, Delivery Girl.
I want to know if you guys think that she took a step up this week, being back with her original partner, or do you think it was about the same level? You know, because how we always want her to be pushed, yeah. And she had such an amazing hard
dance. Samba's a hard dance to do as well, and I think she did pretty good for doing Samba this week.
But I also feel that it was a different intensity dance. It was a different character of a dance. This was more comedy.
Yeah.
This was more fun and kind of flirty versus the tango from the week before was just so intense and so dramatic. It was just a different flavor to me. And I didn't think she stepped down. I think it was kind of like an afternoon mint tea versus a spicy chai.
But also, because it's Disney week, I feel like the competitiveness was kind of put on hold a fraction and Disney just took over.
Interesting.
So it was like the competitiveness was put aside. It was just all about the magic and Disney-ness of the week, which I really enjoyed.
And being delightful.
I love that face, Jules. That was amazing.
And being delightful.
Well, they got a 36.49. Did you guys think that was right on?
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah?
I mean, you can't bring the girl down. Technically, she's very good.
No.
Okay. All right. So we move to Candace and Mark doing the samba to Jungle Book. Not Jungle Book.
Fine. Little Mermaid.
Little Mermaid.
My bad. I was reading something else when I. Yeah.
Stop it, no. Siri.
And I love that she allowed herself to wear an appropriate costume per her character.
Yes.
Given that she likes to stay covered up, which I respect as well. Mm-hmm. I thought it was super fun.
Yeah.
I was smiling and having a good time the whole number. What did you think?
Mark was so funny before, like in the VT, he was doing this whole, you know, the crab thing,
the
like
crab.
The whole time. He was so like, I was in tears, crying, and you know, she danced a good, solid, not too complicated, but yet enough clean samba steps and choreography. You could see her actions. You could see what she was creating. She wasn't trying. It wasn't. Mark was clever this week. He's clever all the time.
He's always clever.
He always does a great job. But he really came. They came in this week to prove a point, which I feel was actually
important.
Maybe one of the couples that did keep the competitiveness was this couple this week.
Right.
I take it back because she nailed it. She nailed it. And I didn't realize how bad she has this problem with nerves. I talked to her after about it.
Wow.
She goes, "Yeah, Jules. Like, I really am not coping with that." And I was really. Stunned that she has that issue, and we had a little chat about it. So hopefully this week she's going to try and get that stuff under control to really, because I still feel like she's ready to burst out a little
Don't even try to get it under control, just channel it differently. Like I still remember one of the gymnasts from Summer Olympics that said, "Oh, I don't think of it as getting nervous. I think of it as getting excited. I just get excited." It's right. You know what I'm talking about.
Yes, I know what you're talking about. And what I want to add to that is the gymnasts or the top athletes that get to those levels, it's because up here is so strong because they have that kind of attitude. And I relate to Candace in that I'm the type of dancer that had to struggle through, like, turn off the brain, you know,
just
like,
do
don't let it interfere. Because when it interferes, you lose some of that performance level, like Mark was talking about and the judges were talking about, which was interesting for them to talk about. I do want to say that I give her props, man. She had the flu all week. She was super sick all week long. So they had shorter rehearsals and didn't, you know what I mean? And it didn't show, in my opinion.
Mm-mm.
I love watching this couple.
She
looked amazing.
She
looked
beautiful,
phenomenal as well last night, and I really, I'm actually really glad that they stayed, because I really think now that she's stayed in as well that we're gonna see some wicked stuff next week.
Yeah,
I do too. I don't think that I never thought she was in jeopardy, even though they said she was in jeopardy. I just never. She's too fun. She's connecting to people.
Yes.
People love her.
Yeah.
I don't know if you thought the same thing, but
I mean, I was worried about her last week because of a score, and I do agree with you that I think they had a proof, you know, they wanted to prove a point that she is here to stay.
Mm-hmm.
And the scores from last week were a little bit too low, like we all discussed that.
Yeah.
I mean, first of all, love Ariel, the whole getup. huge, huge compliments to hair, makeup, and wardrobe right. for both of their outfits, actually.
Absolutely.
I mean, he was like a ballroom version of crap. I mean,
he said they were uncomfortable. Like,
I bet they were. Yeah, but he was like the ballroom version of crap, and it was perfect. Their outfits were so great. Their spirit of the dance was so good, and I feel like Mark does that really, really well with some girls. I felt he did the same thing with Ali Raisman, where Ali is kind of a shy young girl, and Candace is a shy Christian, you know, very conservative woman, and he will put these kind of obnoxious moves, like the crab thing that he did with Candace last night. He will put these obnoxious moves into there that you can't help but laugh as you do them. And I think he does that strategically, and it really works, because the moment she thinks about that step, she's like, oh, there's that step coming, and she's already starts smiling about it. And she even mentioned it in the package. So I think very clever, well done.
I get happy watching them. Yeah. That's the overall feel for them. They got 3 9s and an 8.
Yeah. I would say that's true. That's right.
8 could have been a 9, I felt.
Really?
Really?
No, I felt it
just
been...
compared to what the others were getting. You know, if that's the way we were scoring.
Scores
were
really high overall.
The scores were kind of high for everybody. Yes.
Okay. Well, I mean, that wraps up our dances. So now, predictions. Who is going to go home next week?
And now, you're after Buzz TV.
Who starts? Okay. With Jules.
Ah, darn you, start with me. I'm thinking. You know what I'm thinking?
Just say it.
What are you thinking?
Nini.
Okay. Anna.
Based on the package that they had, I think it's going to really hurt them. So I do feel it's Nini.
Ooh,
feeling it in my waters.
Okay. I would say between Drew and Nini. I'm just going to go with Drew just because it's different than what you guys are going with.
Cool.
So all right, cool. Be different.
Happy with that.
Well, that does it for our show tonight, guys. Thanks for tuning in. And let's go around the table and tell us where we can find you.
At Jules, JULZTOCKER.
What's happening
Twitter,
over there?
Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and everywhere.
We're starting to lose it. Anna, where can we find you?
On Twitter at @Trebunskaya, Instagram Trebunskaya, Facebook and website Anna Trebunskaya.
And at Suri Serrano on everything, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for listening. And thank you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Yeah. We'll see you next week. And
with
Chris
some
will
more
be
people.
Back too. Yes, with a lot more people. Bye.
From executive producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. To watch or listen to other after shows and post comments or questions, be sure to visit AfterBuzzTV.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of AfterBuzz TV.
Buzz you later!
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principal.
Thank you for watching AfterBuzz TV on YouTube. For more of your favorite after shows and interviews, subscribe to our channel here and be sure to share your opinion on the episode in the comment section below here. We'd love to see what you guys are buzzing about. Thanks again. Buzz you later!